Today, the famous TV cameraman focuses on outer space for another exciting adventure in the world beyond tomorrow.
Control deck to all stations. Stand by to raise ship. Blast off minus 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0.
Kraft Caramels, the delicious quick energy treat, presents Tom Corbett's Space Cadet, starring Frankie Thomas. This is the age of the conquest of space, where today a bitter rivalry between two cadet crews at Space Academy sends Tom Corbett and his unit mates rocketing into danger to prove the value of the mighty might.
Well, where are we going to put the trophy, Tom?
Blast your brakes, rocket faster. We haven't even won it yet.
No, but who's going to beat us?
You'll wrap up the pre-fall wrestling event. I ought to take the shot put. And what unit can beat us in space ball or the jet relay?
You know, Astro, you should have told that to Commander Arkwright. He could have called off Space Week and just handed us the cup.
You know what I mean, Tom. I honestly think we've got a darn good chance of winning.
Well, I hope you're right. But don't forget, we haven't got Roger with us this year. And we don't know how TJ will stack up against those bigger fellows in the other events.
Oh, he'll do fine. Of course, if they had an event for practical joking, he'd win hands down.
Well, of course I'll win.
You'll win what?
Well, you name it. Spaceball, jet relay, anything. But back on Mars, they used to call me the terror of the field.
Oh, yes, you are a terror, all right.
What event are you going to enter, TJ? Weightlifting?
No, I'll leave that weight stuff for muscleheads like you.
Ah, come on, fellas. First event starts in half an hour. We better get ourselves organized.
All right, come on, Tom. Who are you waiting for, TJ? Come on.
Yeah, I'll be with you in a second. I'm just choosing the events I'm going to go in. I don't want to win them all, you know.
Oh.
Well, look who's there, Farron. TJ Thistle, boy astrogator.
Hi, Thistle. Picked your events yet?
No, I haven't made up my mind yet, Tom.
Well, don't bother. They don't have kids' games here during Space Week. Why don't you go up to Saturn, play Ring Around the Planet?
Very funny. Let's see what kind of a comic you are when Space Week is over and a Polaris walks off with a trophy.
Oh, I can just picture that. Astro and Corbett carrying the cup and you sitting in it.
Why don't you space creeps get lost?
Hey, how can you see from way down there?
Let me lift you up.
All right.
Let him go.
Look, you dab your tubes, and you better get back to your own outfit and forget it. Well, forget it, all right. I'll forget it the day I cut that space creep down to my size.
Boy. For a little fella, he sure packs a mean wallet.
Well, I don't blame him. You were laying it on pretty thick.
Oh, why? I was only kidding.
Well, from now on, cut it out. You got that guy so worked up about his size, he'll probably outdo himself in all the events.
Go on, he couldn't even beat a midget from Mercury. Corbett and Astro have to carry him in a cup.
I wouldn't be too sure about that, Dennis. The Polaris crew are pretty rough competition.
Space gas, they won't even be in the running. This year, the Vega takes the cup. A present from T.J. Thistle.
Soon with more of today's exciting adventure. But right now, here's Tom Corbett with something special for you.
Hi. You know, a lot of people keep a dish filled with candy around the house. Does your mother do that? Well, if she doesn't, why don't you ask her to? And ask her to keep that dish filled with Kraft caramels. Like this, see? Vanilla caramels, chocolate caramels. Oh, boy, they taste just wonderful. And they're good for you, too. Now, if Mother doesn't know that, you just tell her. Because Kraft caramels are real high quality. All the ingredients are the freshest and the best. Now, you know how good milk is for you. Well, there's a pint and 2/3 of milk in every pound of Kraft caramels. Yes, it sure is a good idea to have a candy dish filled with Kraft caramels around the house. They're soft chewing and they taste swell, the way good caramels ought to taste. Now, you can get them in pound bags, or in half-pound bags, or in handy nickel bars like this, at candy counters everywhere. Each caramel is individually wrapped so that you can carry them around in your pocket. And, say, you remember last week I promised to tell you today how to become a space cadet and get your official class ring and your shoulder patch? Well, we're not quite ready. I thought we would be, but we're not. But the things we're getting together for you are really going to be something. So watch for it next week, okay? Okay.
It's real pretty, doesn't it, Astro? The Vega right there on the top of the heap.
Yeah, you fellas have been doing all right for yourselves. But I wouldn't reach for that space trophy just yet. We're only 2 points behind, you know.
So
it looks like the jet relay will tell the story.
You know, I got a hot space flash for you, Astro. I know the end of the story. You fellas don't stand a chance.
Oh, you don't mind if we enter the race anyway, do you? Just for the experience?
Well, that's all it'll be, experience. Three men can be 2.5 any day.
You better take a brush-up course on your fractions, Dennis. The way I look at it, it's going to be 3 against 3.
Oh, yeah? Well, since when is Thistle a whole man?
All right, listen, you big space lug. Can that kind of talk?
What are you fusing your tubes about? It's true, isn't it? That little shrimp hasn't won a single event all week.
Well, he's trying.
Well, you don't win points for trying. You and Corbett have been carrying a whole...
That's enough.
Oh, he's been an anchor.
That's enough, I said.
All right.
Have it your own way. All you're doing is guaranteeing the cup for the Vega.
Oh, hi, TJ.
I could murder that guy.
All set for the race?
Why is he riding me, Astro? He's been on my back ever since Space Week started.
Look, don't pay any attention to him. He's just blowing off a lot of space gas.
That's right. I haven't racked up a point for the Polaris all week.
Ah, what difference does that make? Look, we're in second place. Now, we're going to overtake the Vega with the jet relay.
Look, we got to win this race to get that trophy. Now, what good are you... I'm no good to you at all.
Well, what are you talking about? This is one event where size doesn't mean a thing.
I hope so. The only one thing I want to do more than anything, and that's make Dennis eat his words.
You will, TJ. Just take it easy now. Don't get over anxious.
Oh, we gotta win that race.
Okay, we will. Calm down, will you?
I'm all right.
Attention! Attention, all crews entered in the final event.
Ready to start the race.
What about Tom?
He's over in the free-fall gym. Let's go. We don't want to be left in the post.
Attention. Here are the positions for the crews on the starting ramp. Orion unit, lane 1. Sirius unit, lane 2. Vega unit, lane 3. Polaris unit, lane 4. Each unit member will check 2.5 laps around the gym before passing the baton to his unit.
Let's just check the running order first. Now, I'm against Astro in the first leg, and Michaels is against Thistle in the second leg, and you're against Corbett in the ankle leg, right?
Check, and that trophy is as good as ours. Oh, I ran into Astro and Thistle. That little shrimp is so nervous he doesn't know which way it is.
Well, I think that's a darn shame. I'm sorry for the poor kid.
Attention. Take your positions on the blasting ramp.
And you go out and get us ahead, Farron.
Do my best.
Clear the starting ramp. All crews prepare to blast.
Thanks, luck, Astro.
Thanks, Farron. Same to you.
All crews stand by. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. At the end of the first lap, Polaris first, Vega second, Orion third, and Sirius last. Second lap, the Polaris is holding its lead. Vega is second, Sirius third, and Orion fourth. The Polaris is now coming up to the passing point. The has lost the baton. La Vega is passing him, going into first place. The Polaris is out of the race.
Oh, boy, those guys are sure living it up, huh?
Yeah, they sure are.
Well, better luck next year.
Say, where's TJ?
I don't know. I thought he came in with me.
Well, blasted, why didn't you keep an eye on him?
What are you heating your tubes about? Never thought losing the space trophy would make you get sore.
Not that, Astro. I'm just worried about the kid. He's blaming himself for fouling up our chances.
He'll be all right. If I know TJ, he'll forget about it by tomorrow. Well, I better go get ready for my shower. I won't be late for mess.
Yeah. I'll see if I can find TJ. Oh, hello, TJ. Where you been?
All around.
You better get out of that suit and shower. You know, a mess calls in 20 minutes.
I'm not hungry.
Come on. Buck up. We finished second, didn't we?
Isn't that just peachy?
Now, what's the matter with second place?
That's the story of my life. I'm always coming in second.
Go on. We'll get him next year.
Yeah, sure you will. You don't have a little punk like me on your team.
Hey, now, wait a minute. You're not letting a space creep like that Dennis bother you.
That's true, isn't it? I have a half pint. Nobody's ever let me forget it. Shorty, Space Squirt, Small Fry. You want to hear any more names? I've been hearing them all my life.
Come off it, TJ. You're making a meteor out of a puff of space dust.
I am, huh? Don't you know me? Haven't you figured me out yet? I'm the guy I like to play practical jokes just so people will know I'm around. All this time, the joke's on me. Dropping the baton like that, the whole academy knows I'm around.
That was just an accident, TJ. And you're way off your orbit about your size. No one even thinks about it. Now, come on. Get dressed. Space Week is over. Tomorrow, we have to blast off on maneuvers. And just remember this. Up there in space, we're all pretty small potatoes.
Well, at least up there, I'll be far away from the Vega crew.
I'm afraid not, TJ. You see, all the ships are running in pairs on this operation. And we're teamed up with the Vega.
Oh, now look, I...
Check in.
Radar bridge, aye.
According to the schedule, we should rendezvous with the Vega in about 20 minutes. You better start a sweep with your radar scanner.
Okay.
How's it going, TJ?
Okay.
You feel all right?
Yeah.
Oh. Well, talk to you later.
What's our rendezvous point, huh?
Sector 12, Nautilus Quadrant of Mars Orbit.
Well, what do we do when we get there?
We're supposed to start coupling and rescue operations with the Vega.
Listen, have you talked to TJ?
Mm-hmm. Just a minute ago. It's like pulling teeth. He's sure being awfully quiet on this trip.
Quiet? It's like a morgue. I can't get used to it. I hop into my bunk and all I find there are nice, clean sheets. No banana skins, no ice cubes. This morning, I squeezed my toothpaste tube, and toothpaste came out of it. I tell you, Tom, that kid's in terrible shape.
Well, better just leave him alone, Astro.
Hey, you don't suppose he's sick, do you?
That depends on how you look at it, Astro. Physically, no. Otherwise, definitely. Why didn't you answer the telephone?
Sorry, Tom. I was thinking about something else.
Well, get with it, will you? We rendezvous in 2 minutes, and we're supposed to start combined rescue exercises right away.
Well, Tom, you and Astro can handle this exercise without me?
Without you? Why?
Oh, it's the Vega crew and that guy Dennis. I'm afraid if I come face to face with him, I'll blow my jets.
Now, listen here, TJ. You've got to stop feeling sorry for yourself. There are three men in this crew, and you're one of them. And if you don't do your job, I'll begin to think maybe Dennis is right. Now get going.
Shut up.
Rocket cruiser Polaris, TJ Thistle here.
Bless you, Thistle. What a chance when I call you.
Who is this?
Baron aboard the Vega. What took you so long?
Didn't Dennis tell you? I have to use a stepladder to reach my control.
All right. This is no time to be funny. We've got trouble. Dennis is sick.
Devil, so am I. I'm sick of him.
Now, listen, this is serious. I think he has appendicitis.
Well, how do you know?
We called Space Academy and described the symptoms to the medics. They want him brought back to Earth fast.
Then you better start blasting.
No, you'll have to. The Polaris is faster than the Vega. Commander Arkwright wants you to bring him back.
Yes.
We're heading back to meet you now. Now, stand by to couple.
No, wait a minute. Fine.
End transmission.
Foreign, you...
Wait on bridge to control deck. Stand by for coupling procedure. We're gonna have coupling.
About a thing. So long, pal.
The bigger they are, the harder they fall.
Oh, you. Blast off, Shorty. Leave me alone.
Oh, that's no way to treat a friend. I just came down to make you feel better. You've always gotten a big laugh out of me. I just thought I'd cheer you up.
Hey, leave me alone, Thistle. I'm sick.
So am I, Dennis. I'm sick of your wisecracks and your insults.
Well, listen. You're not going to hold that against me, are you? I need help. You got to help me.
A little squirt like me help you?
Oh, not the pistol.
I'll fuse your tubes. We'll get you back. In fact, I can't get you back and off this ship fast enough.
TJ, where have you been?
I was in the bunk room seeing Dennis.
Well, that's a switch, isn't it? I didn't know you two were exactly buddies.
We're not. In fact, I like him less than ever.
He's a pretty sick cookie, TJ.
What am I supposed to do, bust into tears?
No. All I want you to do is to get topside and plot me a heading. We're blasting back to Earth under emergency speed. Because whether you care about it or not, this is going to be a race against death.
Let's get back to Earth for a minute or so while we see what our young craft cooks, Casey and Candy, are going to cook today. Craft caramel sundaes. Vanilla ice cream with big slurps of smooth, creamy caramel sauce made with Kraft Dairy Fresh caramels. Casey and Candy think this is almost as much fun making the sauce as it is eating it. So they're going to show you how they do it now, the easy Kraft way, so you can do it at your house. Get a double boiler with some hot water in the bottom, a tablespoon, and a rubber spatula. A half cup of milk, or hot water will do, and of course a bag of those wonderful Kraft Dairy Fresh caramels. There are 28 delicious caramels in every half-pound bag. You just unwrap the caramels, all 28 of them, and put them in the top of the double boiler. Then, put in the half a cup of milk or water you measured out. Now get Mother to do this part, stirring the caramels and milk over the hot water on the stove till the mixture looks like this. Smooth and creamy and licking good. There's your Kraft caramel sauce. Just pour it in a pitcher. Some like it hot, some like it cold, but everybody loves that real caramel flavor. Of course, it's scrumptious on ice cream, but try it on vanilla pudding, too. Kraft caramels come in half-pound and pound bags like these, and in nickel bars that make dandy after-school snacks. You'll find Kraft caramels at candy counters everywhere.
Hey,
Conduct to power deck. Check in.
Morning, guy.
Are the rocketed temperatures, Astro?
Aye, but still below the danger point.
Good. We're making better time than I expected. Stick with it.
How are we doing, Tom?
All right, TJ.
How's Dennis?
Not so good.
You think we'll make it back in time?
It's going to be close.
Can't you get any more speed out of the ship?
We're on emergency speed now. I didn't know you were so interested, TJ.
Well, just because I don't like the guy doesn't mean I want to see him die.
Well, I'm glad to hear that.
Oh, come on. Don't you start giving me the needle, too.
As I see it, TJ, no one's giving you the needle but yourself.
What do you mean?
You figure that out yourself. And I just hope you get a good answer before we get back to work.
I think we're in trouble.
Right. What's wrong, Astro?
Well, I'm not sure, but we're losing pressure. And there's a strange noise coming from these fuel pumps. Listen.
You think the master's...
instruments.
Look, Astro. The main fuel lines run below these pumps, don't they?
Yeah, they come up from the fuel tanks between the outer skin of the ship and the fuel tank wall. Why?
You think there could be a leak in one of the lines?
Well, I suppose there could.
Can we get to the leak?
You know how big that space is between the skin of the ship and the fuel tank walls? Just about that big. Be a rough job even for a kid to wriggle through there.
Somebody paging me?
DJ.
How big you say that space was, Astro?
That big?
Tom, you got.
Oh, wait a minute. What about your spacesuit and helmet, TJ?
What do I need all that for? Come on, give me a hand, Astro.
Now look, TJ, if you go in there without a spacesuit on, there's nothing between you and space but the wall of the ship, supposing that cracks.
Cracks? What, are they making ships out of wood these days?
Oh, now cut the kidding, TJ. Anything could happen. Suppose the leak spreads. Well, suppose the line breaks altogether.
Well, you can suppose a lot of things. All I know is this. If we don't get Dennis back in time, he's through. And I'm the only guy in the ship who can help get him back in time. So let's not talk about it anymore. I'll be wasting time. How do I get in there?
Well, you could crawl through this access door, huh?
Mm-hmm. Well, open it up.
Listen, TJ, if you can't reach that leak, you come right back here because a dead hero won't help us one bit.
Okay, sure. Let's have the repair kit, huh?
Oh.
Okay, TJ. She's open.
Oh, man, I gotta do some plain and fancy rigging.
All right, here's the kit, TJ. Now, the patches are inside. Just slap them on. They'll hold.
Okay. Here goes.
Listen, TJ.
Yeah.
Are you sure you really want to go through with this?
Not a question of wanting to go through with it, Tom. I've got it. You understand?
Yeah, TJ. I understand. Spaceman's luck.
Thanks. See you, boys.
Well, he may be a little guy, but he's got a giant-sized courage.
And I sure hope he'll be all right.
I better get topside. Try and keep this ship steady.
TJ? TJ, can you hear me? TJ!
Thank you.
I'll check in. Listen, any word from TJ yet?
No.
Well, have you tried calling down to him?
No, I'm hoarse. No answer.
Okay. Talk to you later. Oxygen gear down there on the line. I'm going to get to him from the outside.
The outside?
Yeah, I'll take a space torch and burn through the hull.
Pretty destructive, aren't you?
TJ! TJ, are you all right?
Yes, give me a hand.
Glad to see your ugly mug again.
You admire the scenery later. Get those neutrons, Papa.
Hey, did you fix the leak?
What do you think I was doing down there? Playing solitaire.
Oh, good work, TJ. All right, Astro, stand by to let her rip.
Something I learned something down there. Something important.
You did, TJ? What?
I'm gonna make these ships bigger.
Astro, full space speed!
Okay, Dennis. We've landed at Space Academy. They're sending over a stretcher, and you'll be in sick bay in no time flat.
Thanks, Tom. Well, Tom, listen. Astro told me what TJ did. Is that true?
Yeah, it is.
Well, is he around?
Sure. It's right here.
Come here, you little space creep.
What do you want, you big knucklehead?
I just want to shake hands with the biggest man in Space Academy.
Saturday morning, the makers of Kraft Caramels take you to the world beyond tomorrow. Don't forget to be with us for next week's exciting adventure of Tom Corbett, Space Cadet. Starring Frankie Thomas and featuring Al Markham and Jack Grimes. Presented by Kraft Caramels.